Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through some examples for the selection of check valves for refrigeration applications. Coming up, selecting a check valve for compressor's discharge line, selecting a check valve for the liquid line, generating a report, and generating a bill of materials. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the Cool Selector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So do check out the other videos if you haven't already. Links are in the video description below. We start the selection process for a check valve by first heading to the Valves and Line Components tab and then selecting the Check Valve option. As this is a commercial application, we'll change our preferences to show the most relevant products. To do this, simply click on Options in the top menu bar and then click on Preferences and then select Commercial Applications. We begin in the top left-hand panel by first selecting the system type. In this case, we'll use a dry system. We can then select where in the system the valve will be installed using the system schematic. In this case, we require a check valve for the discharge line. Next, we choose which refrigerant our system is using. We'll choose R513A from the drop-down menu. We can also choose the connection type, but for this example, I'll leave this as all. Next, we define the operating conditions. For this example, we'll choose a cooling capacity of 45 kilowatts, an evaporation temperature of negative 10 degrees Celsius with 8 kelvins of useful superheat and an additional superheat of 4 kelvins from the suction line. For the condensation temperature, we'll input 42 degrees Celsius with a subcooling of 2 kelvin. The Products Family section lists the available products. We can hover our mouse over the titles to see a small photo as well as a brief product description. When we are selecting a valve for a discharge line, we should always pay attention to the compressor and the capacity as it is important for the proper functioning of the valve. You'll notice in the product families list we have NRV and NRVH. These are almost identical products except that the NRVH has a stronger spring to provide a tighter seal on the port. The NRV valve has standard strength springs while the NRVH check valves are equipped with a stronger spring to form a tight seal and protect against refrigerant flowing back from the discharge line and into the cylinders of the compressor. When reciprocating compressors are used in parallel or in a power pack, they will generate a lot of pressure pulsation. This is where the NRVH valve should be used. Furthermore, to avoid piston oscillation, partially open check valves in the discharge line should be avoided. For this example, we'll assume parallel reciprocating compressors are used and therefore choose the NRVH valves. The window will now refresh to display some product information. For the selection criteria, we can choose between pressure drop and velocity. For this example, I'll use velocity and leave the values as default. The table now shows a list of available products. Some products have red text. This is warning us that there is a compatibility issue with our system. We can view the warning by hovering our mouse over the warning symbol in the rightmost column. Additionally, a warning message will display above the table if we select the product. You will notice that one row is highlighted in green. This is the suggested product. This is only a suggestion and you should check the performance details to ensure it suits your system and requirements. You'll see in the table the pressure drop across the valve. You can also see that the load for this valve and system is 126%. This is the current load divided by the load required to fully open the valve. As we mentioned earlier, you should always make sure that the check valves are fully open in the discharge line. In our case, the system part load is 22.5 kilowatts. By replacing the capacity with this value, we can see that the suggested check valve is no longer applicable to our system as it is partially open. This shows the importance of considering the part load and other parameters to ensure that your selected product suits your system and requirements. If you would like to see details on the performance and the calculations, you can do so by going to Options, Preferences, Edit Preferences, and then check the Show Performance Curve and Performance Details in the Valves and Line Components tab. You'll then have to save this preference. We mentioned how to create and edit preferences in our video about tools and preferences. Make sure to check that out as well as our other videos. Links are in the video description below. In the lowest section of the window, we have the code number selection for our selected product. Here we can find the product code numbers for the different connection types. We can then generate a report as well as a bill of materials, and we'll look at how to do that towards the end of this video. If we want to then add a check valve to the same system in the liquid line, we can click on the New tab and then select the Valves and Line Components tab and then select Check Valves. Notice that Cool Selector has kept the same system, refrigerant and operating conditions. As this check valve is for the condenser line, we will select the liquid line from the system schematic. In the product family section, we again have the option for the NRV or the NRVH check valve with a stronger spring. As there are little to no vibrations or gas pulsations in the liquid line, we can therefore select a standard NRV check valve. Additionally, because there are little to no vibrations, a partially open condition is possible. This is down to the minimum pressure drop. We can see that the suggested product is the NRV22 valve. We see the pressure drop across the valve is 0.026 bar at full load, and the minimum pressure drop for the valve to operate is 0.02 bar. If the valve operates below this, the valve will become unstable. To check the part load condition, we can now halve the capacity from 45 kW to 22.5 kW to simulate a part load condition. We see that NRV22 has a pressure drop of 0.021 bar, which is above the minimum pressure drop and indicates stable operation. When the pressure drop is near or equal to the minimum pressure drop, another model should be considered. Additionally, we can see that the saturation temperature drop is low at 0.1 Kelvin. This is important because a high pressure or temperature drop could lead to refrigerant flashing to a gas phase in the liquid line. In the code number selection tab, we can find the product's code numbers for different connection types. We can then generate a report as well as a bit of materials, and we'll see how to do that in the next part of this video. We can generate a report for our selected product simply by clicking on the report button in the top menu bar. The window will now refresh to display our product report. In the left-hand panel, under Items to include in the report, we can add or remove information from our report by clicking on the plus button and then selecting or unselecting the items. If we make a change here, simply click the update button at the top to apply these changes. Additionally, we have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name to the report using the inputs on the top of the left-hand panel. Again, if you make a change here, then simply click the update button to apply these. Along the top of the report, we also have various options to export the report. We can generate a bill of materials which can be provided to a Danfoss supplier to obtain a quotation by clicking on the bill of materials button in the top menu bar. Here, the product quantity, product description, and the code numbers will be displayed. In the left-hand panel, we also have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name by using the inputs. If you make a change here, simply click the update button to apply this. Along the top of the bill of materials, we also have a number of buttons to export the bill of materials. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed this and it has helped you. If so, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you have any questions at all, let us know in the comment section down below. You can find links to more Cool Selector 2 tutorials in the video description. Do check those out. And once again, thanks for watching.